have Julie Dutchess going to be talking to us today about organizational apps for high school and college students. So the floor is yours, Julie.
Well, thank you very much. So for organizational apps, and we have a half hour, but I wanted to kind of give you a variety of different apps to kind of put in your little toolbox. So we're going to, instead of going back and forth and doing some live stuff, I did pull in videos so you could at least see some of these apps in action or what they might do, so you could kind of get a better view of that. So with that, we will say one size does not fit all. So please know that there are multiple apps that might work for the individual or the student that you're working with, or if it's yourself, but we all have different needs, approaches, learning styles, and preferences. So for example, the stuff that I use may not work for my coworker or my husband or whatever. We all have different ways that we learn and what we feel aesthetically may even be more pleasing to us than someone else. So there's multiple ones, but so it's good to kind of look around and see which one fits the best. And I also wanted to start off with some resources because, again, there's multiple apps out there, more than we can talk about. So I wanted to give you these. So Bridging Apps is a really good resource for you to go and click and search and filter the apps. And so you can go by like specific age, different categories, price, if you only want to look at the free ones, different ones like that. And so skill level, and then it'll filter it down and give you the apps that fit those filters. iAccessibility.com, you can see there where it's like accessible, fun and games, blind, cognitive and intellectual, deaf, deaf blind, general, hard of hearing, low vision, mobility, and speech. Those are the different categories that you can look and explore the different apps that they have there. And then also Tech Out is a really nice resource where you can go there and you can click on apps for our whole life. And again, it's categorical. And so you can click on, for example, for today, you could have done like organization, cognitive, and it would bring up some apps that might be useful. And then also if you click on the consider AT solutions, what it does is ask you a couple questions and you fill it in. So like, what do I do well and what am I struggling with? And what kind of subject matter am I wanting to look at? And it gives you a multiple list of different AT that might be a good option for that. And so with that, it not only does the apps, but it will also give you some other like software and equipment too. So let's dive in to what we're gonna be looking at. So there's different categories within organizational apps. A lot of times we just think of the schedulers and the calendars, but there's also multiple things too. So we've got note-taking, student planner, to-do lists, tab managers, time tracking management, writing and mind mapping, Pomodoro, flashcard, and project management. So for the first one, the note-taking, which is Evernote, that's one that I wanted to highlight. And so if you look on the left, you'll see what my app looks like when I'm using it. So it has like your home, has your notes, your tasks, the different notebooks, and things like that. And so when we're talking about note-taking apps, they're kind of like digital notebooks, if you will, that let you kind of like jot down your thoughts and such. So when it comes to Evernote, it's one that's been around for a while. And it's pretty much when you look at different, like what's the best apps out there, it tends to be on a lot of the lists. So it does a lot, it clicks a lot of the check marks. There we go. It helps students organize a wide variety of file formats, such as text, contacts, task lists, image files, such as photos of like they could take a class discussion, they could take a picture of the whiteboard and put it in with their notes, paper handouts, they could do that and put it in. You can do audio and video files with it. It has a web clipper that we're going to show you a very short clip of. And then it also has, I want to mention the school note templates. So it makes it taking notes a little bit easier and more efficient. So it has like templates for class notes, project overviews, checklists, story premise, research tracker, and things like that. So I wanted to show you this little video here.
capture any idea, no matter when it comes, so you can find it fast and build on it later.
Okay, but my projects are piling up, and I have to manage to-dos for all of them. Can you help me out?
We have your tasks organized by project or due date, and we can even help you prioritize your...
Hold up. That one's due today. Ugh, that means I have to hunt down a bunch of notes and files and links and...
Actually, all your tasks live inside your notes, right with all your docs, PDFs, links, and web pages.
Sorry, just one more thing. I've got so much going on, and sometimes things get lost in the shuffle. Can I get a reminder? Okay, good. I'm good now.
I hear you, guy. My schedule is packed, and I need to keep track of what happens in every meeting. Can you help with that?
Sure thing. We'll just connect your calendar to your notes and set up reminders to open the right note right when you need it.
I gotta go. I need to get ready for a big meeting, and I don't have time for this.
Wait,
so you can see it has a lot of different things, and it's all kind of in one. So it's syncing your schedules with your notes. It's doing your notes with your to-do lists. It brings it all together. So that makes it really, really nice. And then also we had mentioned
capture any idea, no matter when it comes.
And so I just wanted you to get your eyes on it, what it means when we talk about a web clipper. Up here too, because you can see here where you can bookmark it, you can take it where it doesn't have all of the ads and things like that. It can be a short view. And then also what that video showed was that you can also annotate. So you can add different things, like they do it in arrow, but you can add text to it. You can add all these different things just with that web clipper alone. Evernote used to just be totally free. It's not anymore, but you can do a lot of things that are free on there. You can see that you can sync up, two devices. All these things right here come on the free. If you need more, then you can pay. It's $8.99 a month, or if you want the professional one, that's $9.99 a month. You can also pay annually, which is $79.99. But so that just kind of gives you a breakdown of what comes with each of those. But it's pretty robust for the free version still, I will say. Another good note-taking is OneNote with Immersive Reader. It's very similar to Evernote in a way that it organizes the text and the multimedia documents into separate notebooks. And you can add subsections within the notebooks as well. You can document your ideas by recording audio and video into your notebook. So you can have all those different ways that you learn included in your notes. It's accessible on multiple devices, and it can be used for real-time collaboration. And also, this is pretty cool, is that it does let you take your handwritten notes and scan it and convert them to text. And then what I also really like is, because I mentioned it has Immersive Reader. So Immersive Reader comes in with the Microsoft Office. And this is one of the Microsoft Office suite tools. But anyways, Immersive Reader will read text aloud and highlight as it goes. And it'll read any of the text that's in your notes, any text that might be in a picture, embedded in a picture or something like that. And so that's really cool to have that text being able to read aloud with OneNote. OneNote does have a cost because it is part of the Microsoft suite. There is a free version that does some, but the more robust is when you get it with the suite. So then I wanted to talk about the student planner, and the first one is my study life. And so you can kind of see what it looks like. I took some screenshots of it so you can kind of see. So basically it keeps track of more than just your homework. The app can send reminders on upcoming exams, revisions to your assignments. It can also notify you of incomplete tasks. So you know exactly when projects or assignments that you still need to work on. It also gets Reminders for upcoming classes. So you don't have to have that stress of, okay, what's next? What do I got to do? You know, it takes that anxiety a little bit away. And then it also, it's free. It's a free one. And it syncs with Android, iPhone, Windows Phone, and then also does the web browsers as well. And what I kind of like, I love color coding. That's one of the things that I use a lot that my brain seems to work with. So you can give like every class a color. And so when you're looking at that, you can kind of focus in on, okay, these are my class. This is my class, my math class that's on these days. This is what's due. You can open up the individual class and see the assignments coming up. Again, like I said, you can do the reminders as well with those. And then another one is my homework, and it does, it's very similar, but remember what I said, you have different aesthetics, it has different functions that may work best for you. So with my homework, it combines your calendars and widgets to help you track assignments, projects, important events, upcoming exams. So it's pretty much, you know, it's doing the same thing as the other one. It does have a free version, and it does pretty well with it. This one though, I kind of do like the paid version because it's $4.99 a year, but with it, you can do file attachments. So I like being able to bring in the files and put it there with the students that I'm working with. I know that helps them out quite a bit. It also does external calendar access. So if they have a calendar that they like, they can import it in. And then you can also share it if you want to, but it works with iPads, Chromebooks, Android, iPhone, Windows, and Mac. So the next one is the to-do list. And one of them that I've been using for quite a while with, I use it myself and I also use it with other individuals that I've worked with a lot, and that's AnyDo. The reason I like AnyDo too is because it does mesh quite well with, like, if you have smart home, it syncs really well with Alexa and things like that. You can have all your tasks, appointments, due dates right in front of you. And each one can have reminders, which are very helpful. And you can add instructions to like a homework assignment. You can bring in files and notes to it. So again, it's all in one place, and that's what's helping us out with those. And I have a short little video on how you even create a task.
Adding and completing tasks are at the heart of any well-organized and productive lifestyle. Get started by creating your first task. To add an item, you can simply start writing in the quick add input bar and add as many items as you need, tapping the blue arrow to save. Alternatively, you can use the plus icon to add tasks and jump right into your full task menu. Under the task title, you'll be able to add more details like reminders, color tags, subtasks, notes, and more. Once you're done editing, tap the Save button or simply pull the task down. When you're done with a task, just swipe left to right or tap the checkbox. Every completed task will automatically move to the bottom of each section so that your upcoming tasks stay on top and you can direct your focus to what's coming next. Want to archive your completed tasks? Just shake your device or open the menu and choose Clear Completed. With every archive, you'll see a productivity score showing you just how many tasks you've completed with AnyDo thus far. While these items will be cleared from your view to make room for new ones, you will still be able to find their record under the completed task section.
And I wanted to show you too, because they were only showing you kind of the list view, but it also does the one where you can put it, it's almost like little note tabs, like little note cards or post-it notes, there we go, where you can have it like to do, doing, done, like upcoming, you know, however you want to label it, but it kind of lets you move tasks along the way, which is a great visual for some people. So I wanted to show you that it not only has the list view, but it also has it that way as well. Okay. There we go. Okay. So tab managers. Okay. So this one is technically an extension. It's not really an app per se, but I wanted to add it today because when we're talking about organization, some of the things that when I'm working with students and some of my coworkers, I've seen you out there, y'all have all these tabs at the top. And so then you're like spending time trying to figure out where, which tab you need and things like that. So this is a way that you can actually organize the tabs at the top of your page. And it's Workana. It's free for students. For everybody else, it's $7 a month, but it is free for students. But I also wanted to mention before I show the video that you can do this with Google as well. So if you're in Google Chrome and you have your tabs up there, if you right click on a tab, it'll bring up some options and you can create groups. And then you can add different tabs into that group, and it's color coded and things like that. So, and that's free as well. So, but I wanted to go ahead and show you this Workana app or extension.
If you have too many tabs open in your browser, Workana's Tab Manager is the perfect solution. It'll help you organize your tabs into dedicated workspaces so you can focus on one project at a time. First, make sure the Tab Manager extension is installed and tab management is enabled. To get organized, start by dragging a group of related tabs to the top of the sidebar to move them to a new workspace. Now give that workspace a name, like quarterly planning, if that's one of the projects you're working on. Now you can repeat the process. Drag some other related tabs to a new workspace and give the workspace a name. We'll call this one Client Rebrand. When we open Client Rebrand workspace, notice that all the tabs we just moved in appear in the window. When we switch to the quarterly planning workspace, notice that all the client rebrand tabs have been hidden and all the quarterly planning tabs swap into this window. If you realize there's another tab you want in here, you can just open it in the window and it will appear next to the other tabs. Now, not only do these tabs show up when you click the workspace, they're auto-saved. The cloud icon with the check mark means you can leave the workspace, close it, and when you come back, your tabs are still there. When you're in a workspace, think of the tabs you open as belonging to that workspace. However, if a tab makes it into a workspace that doesn't belong there, you can easily move it by using the Tab Manager extension button. All you have to do is click the button, type in the workspace the tab belongs to, and move it. Now, if you don't see the button up there, be sure to pin it. Sometimes you can end up with a lot of tabs within a given workspace. Rather than keeping everything open, saving some of those tabs as resources can help you stay organized and focused. Think of resources like a bookmark folder for the project. To save a tab as a resource, click the plus button and select a tab. Now I can close the tab and easily reopen it the next time I need it. You can also save a resource right from your current tab using the Tab Manager extension button. Now that you've added your resources,
so with if that you have one, too many tabs, what he just goes on to say is then you can also do sub categories underneath each one if you want, and do it that way as well. And it saves on your computer when you do that. And for Workana, it's with Chrome, Firefox, Microsoft Edge, and it has a 4.8 rating in the Google Web Store. So it's well received. So it's a good one to kind of think of. One part of better organizing your life is also figuring out in your student life is to figure out how you're spending your time. So time tracking apps can help with that and hopefully help you figure out where to improve. The A tracker lets you track any activity at any time and will let you know when things are taking too long, or if you're ahead of schedule. And what I really like, and if you are interested in this, is if you go to A Tracker, their website, they have a free live demo where you can actually go and click around and play with it and see how it interacts. But I'll give you this little video just so you can see a visual of what it looks like.
A Tracker, manage your time beautifully. Easy and elegant, A Tracker is a time tracking app that is very easy to use and requires minimal setup. Keep track of your time. Start and stop a task by just one tap. Create beautiful reports. Share and sync data across platforms and devices. All tasks are listed in the Today tab, where you can start or stop by one single touch. By tapping a different task, the previous one will be stopped automatically. All historical task entries are displayed in Calendar tab or History tab. Here you can also manually add or modify an entry.
So you can see on that one as well, you can do the color coding. And but it's a really good visual because I've worked with where they're like, I just seem like I'm running out of time. I don't know where I'm getting lost at. And so it's really kind of good to break it down to see, and we do it by classes as well for like homework assignments and things like that. So they can see how long it's actually taking them to do it. And you can see the prices there. It's free. The free version works really well, but if you want to do unlimited tasks or like if you want different colors available or no ads, then it's $4.99, and that's a one-time cost, which is nice. And if you have an Apple Watch, it syncs really nicely, but you would have to do the paid version of that. The next one is mind mapping. A lot of people are very familiar with mind mapping. It helps students with multiple, maybe they're having difficulties with remembering or organizing their thoughts and ideas and their research. And so what's really nice about Simple Mind, as well as some of the other ones, you can have this beautiful graphic organizer, because especially if someone's more visual, that's how they learn. That's me. It gives you that very nice visual image, and then you can flip it into an outline that can be imported into a Word processor or Word document or Google Doc. And then you can take that outline and the image and then start writing, and you have all your thoughts right there, and it keeps you focused and it keeps you organized. It's not just for writing though. It can be for like planning tasks, planning events, different things like that. It can be a reminder of your day. And so it gives you like check boxes, and you can change the borders and things like that. And so that's mind mapping, and that's what it kind of looks like there. And you can just take your main idea and start branching off of it. And you can see like the different colors again. So it's really quick and easy to kind of be organized with your thoughts. Here we go. So one of the last ones is the Pomodoro one. And so that is your focus keeper is one of them. And so basically what this is it's based on the thing where you work for 25 minutes in 25 minute chunks, and then you get a 5 minute break in between each burst of activity, if you will. So you choose the task to be done, you set the timer for 25 minutes, you focus on the task until the timer rings. And you can have different sounds embedded in it. You can have sound playing if you want. I'm one that cannot stand like the sound of a clicking clock, so I would never want that one. But you can have like beach music or whatever to like kind of have that white noise for that 25 minutes to help you stay focused. And then you take a short break and it's 5 minutes. And then once you've done 4 focus rounds, then you can take a longer break for 20 or 30 minutes. It's free to download. And the subscriptions are 99 cents a month or $5.99 annually. And then also some of them come with this one where you can actually break it down and really like task manage, like how long it's going to take you to do different things. And so this is another visual that goes with the app. So it's really nice how that works as well. And then this one is, I've heard it different ways, but flashcards, it's Anki or Anki. I don't know, but it's really nice when you need flashcards. And so this is one that I kind of put together so you could kind of see what it looks like. So basically I gave my deck, it's called a deck, a name. And then my deck was assistive technology, and it was organizational apps was the front of my flashcard. And then this is on the back. So like, this is what it looks like. And I'm like, okay, organizational apps. What are some organizational apps that we've talked about? And I go through them, and then I hit show answer. And then it comes over here and there's my answer. And then down here, if I didn't get it and I'm like, oops, then I would hit again and I could be retrained on it. Or if I said it's hard, good, or easy, then it kind of takes it and puts it into a format. So if I thought it was easy, it wouldn't show me that as much when I was going through the deck. It would actually kind of put it on a less frequency one. And then Trello. Oh, and I think I said it was free, and it's on Windows, Mac, Android, Linux, iPhone, and Android. And then Trello, think of it as like a virtual whiteboard where you can create like the post-its. It's kind of like the one we talked about earlier for a task. And you can have multiple boards. You can collaborate with people and assign different tasks to your group. So if you're doing a group project, and then when the task's finished, you can move it to the next stage. And so that's really nice. So that's Trello. And it's the free version is really good. Like I don't think I've ever had anybody pay for the $6 a month one, but if you want to, and you feel like you need it, you can do that, but their free version is really robust. And then finally ClickUp. I think I have time.
We all know the crazy chaos caused by trying to use more than one app for productivity. There has to be a better way to work. It's time for change. That's why we created ClickUp. ClickUp is an entire productivity platform that keeps all of your work organized in one beautifully intuitive place. Now you can use one app for everything. With ClickUp, plan and create custom views that you can share with anyone. Tasks, calendars, docs, spreadsheets, timelines, goals, mind maps, and you can even embed custom views.
You can see that was like an all-encompassing one. And it's free, and it has... Oh, and the post-it note things, if you ever see it, it's the Kanban boards, the ones that you move across, like post-it notes. So that's what that is. But you can see the free version, again, is pretty robust. It's just if you want the unlimited of everything, then you would pay $5 a month. And then finally, just some other apps, if you want to jot them down. These are some of the ones that I couldn't quite talk about, but my goodness, I use them all the time. So Google Keep, Glean, the Padlet is great for collaboration and project management, Notion, RimNote. Now RimNote, if you have somebody that has cognitive issues, I would not give them RimNote. It's very robust. It's a lot of intricate little things that it can do. And so that's one that I would not use for that. Raindrop.io is a good bookmark manager. So when you're doing research, Todoist is another to-do list. And Teemo is a really nice visual daily planner. And so that's all I have. So thank you. It's a lot, I know.
All right. So thank you, Julie, for that wonderful presentation. That was a lot of really, really great information, which we all really appreciate. Now, feel free, everyone, if you have questions for Julie or just for us in general, please feel free to drop them in the Zoom chat or unmute your mic and ask them. We had one question earlier from Cynthia. She's asking, does Evernote have a dark high contrast option for the user interface? So a dark mode.
So can you go in and actually click on it? No. Could you play around with your built-in functions on your computer? Yes, but just that, no, it does not, that I'm aware of.
Right. And then we had another question from Cynthia. When and where are these webinars posted? Sarah responded in the Zoom chat for a playlist with all of the DHHS playlists where we keep our NCATP playlists as well. Typically we caption these and we put them on our YouTube channel. That usually takes about a week. So just check back in a week or so and you should be able to see this one. But in the meantime, feel free to check out all of the ones that we have done previously. We also have Susan in the chat saying, great job. So I agree, really great job.
Thank you. Right. And, so, you know, again, if you ever see these in action, I always tell people, you know, please feel free to reach out to the center, the AT center that's closest to you. We all have different apps, you know, downloaded on our iPads or on our computers that you can come in and look at, so you can kind of get a feel for them as well. And a lot of them have free demos and free trials as well.
Mm-hmm. Just a reminder, you guys, we do these AT for all calls bi-weekly, so every 2 weeks. We're going to be missing our next one in 2 weeks because of the Wilmington pop-up. So feel free to look in your email for the one after that. Okay, and Cynthia left another message. Great, thank you. We have a transitions workshop coming up for DSDHH, Western Region. I will share this as a resource with our regional manager. So there you go.
Oh, great.
All right, perfect. So if there's no other questions or comments, you guys, thank you for joining us and we'll see you all next time. Enjoy the rest of your week.
Thank you.